we decided to look at an experiment that I had done as a postdoc, where I had added a drug called Brefeldin A that had been touted to block secretory trafficking. And when we added that drug, we found that a particular subcompartment within the cell called the Golgi apparatus disassembled. Essentially, it redistributed its contents from the Golgi back into the ER. Now, when I had made this discovery as a postdoc, it was only done in fixed cells, where we were just looking at fixed time points after the addition of the drug. It was an exciting result because the compartment that was disassembling, the Golgi apparatus, had previously been thought to be a stable structure that could not be created or destroyed within the cell. In fact, as a graduate student, I remember writing down in my notebook a quote from George Pilotti saying, the Golgi apparatus cannot be created or destroyed. It's like a mitochondria. It's pre-existing in some way. And I remember thinking, well, how do you really know that? You know, what's the proof for that? And I was seeing as a postdoc in front of me a drug that caused that Golgi to disappear. So that went against a basic tenet that had been accepted in the field. So I knew that was going to be interesting to study. But it was very hard to study it when you were only using fixed materials because you didn't have a temporal aspect to the system. So as soon as it was clear that using fluorescent protein technology, where you could tag a protein of interest with a fluorescent beacon, so to speak, a GFP molecule, and now track those molecules from one place to another, I realized that we could finally watch how the Golgi apparatus disassembled in the presence of this drug, Brefeldin A. And it was truly amazing. We knew it took on the order of about 10 minutes for the whole process to happen, but I wasn't expecting that it was going to happen in 10 seconds. Basically, when we were doing, we essentially set up our microscope and was just doing continuous imaging. And this was all done by hand at the time. We didn't have fancy microscopes like we have now, where you just program it and it starts taking the image whatever time period you want. We were doing everything by hand. And I remember at one point, in about 19 seconds after adding this drug, the Golgi sort of looked like it was going slightly out of focus, and we started seeing these tubes spew out of this organelle. And within 10 seconds, everything started blurring out, and we saw all the material redistribute from the Golgi back into the endoplasmic reticulum. It was absolutely mind-blowing. The material in the Golgi, over a very short period, within about 3 or 4 seconds, was swept from the Golgi into the endoplasmic reticulum, and that was the end of that organelle until we removed the drug. When BFA is washed out from cells, the Golgi apparatus reassembles. This occurs as a result of Golgi enzymes that were trapped in the ER during Brefeldin A treatment, now being able to be exported out of the ER into transport intermediates that fuse together to form a new Golgi structure. Although initially we didn't really know how it was working, many people in the field subsequently then jumped into it to try to understand what exactly is this drug doing. And what we found as a field was that it's inhibiting a small GTPase called ARF that regulates the assembly of coproteins onto the surface of membranes. And these are the same coproteins that Rothman and Scheckman had been talking about in their in vitro and genetic assays.